Mr. and Mrs. Peter Suzuki. We have Connor, Claire, and Noah. We have Sierra and Ethan. And now, please, time to welcome and introduce Mr. and Mrs. Trevor Martin.
Walk her down the aisle for a wedding, which has meant more to me than she can imagine. I became a stepdaddy over 11 years ago to two young adults when Penny and I were married. Years have had their ups and downs, more ups than downs. Getting to know each other, it's been a very rewarding journey with some wonderful highs, high school and college graduations, watching them climb the job ladders, and four wonderful grandchildren, Sierra, Ethan, Connor, and Claire. I'm proud to call Laura daughter and Matt son. That is truly an honor. A while back, we were introduced to Trevor, and have had the great pleasure of getting to know him and another wonderful grandchild, Noah. Although they seem to have been family all along, we're so happy to have them officially join the family. Now you're stuck with us. Laura and Trevor, they have been good together and have already accomplished so much. I am sure there's more to continue. And just, I'm sure you've heard this over and over this afternoon, but be good to each other, be understanding and forgiving, continue the journey from two separate people into one combined, and from a family of five to a family of seven. Love you, Laura, and Trevor, all of the grandkids. Wish you great success as you continue your journey in life together as a family. Thank you.
Hey, Mark Shopper. Mr. and Mrs. Martin, today is a celebration of love. I think everyone invited here would agree that you two are very much in love. But this is not a wedding that we would normally attend. Both of you are embarking on a life together that includes second marriages and an instant family of five kids. You have been through a lot and have learned a lot. So I'm not going to stand up here and try to tell you what makes for a happy, successful marriage. The rest you will learn every day for the rest of your lives. And Trevor, you can take comfort in knowing that after 43 years of marriage, your dad is still learning every day. What I will tell you is that we are very happy for the both of you. And what we have seen over the past few years is that you truly are a team that not only wants the best for each other, but the best for these kids. And that love doesn't end with your own. Each is uniquely yours. To say that we are very proud of the man you are, Trevor, is an understatement. We see what a great dad you are to Noah and how much he loves having brothers and sisters, only being sad when he is not with them. The kids love one another so much that there is no starting or stopping point. Just five brothers and sisters growing up together as one family unit. Only a real man would love a woman so much that he would also love her four kids as his own, and you do. You may not be their father, but you surely are their dad, the same great dad Noah has. Every time we are together, we see that the kids love you more, and it's so clear that you are such an important figure in their lives. They look up to you and respect you. You will be their role model as they grow up, guiding them on the right path to a successful life, and you will have the privilege of knowing everything you have done for them was worth it, the same privilege your dad and I have had. Laura, over a short period of time, you have become an important part of this family. With all the laughter, gossip, drama, and wine, you quickly became one of us as if overnight. You have taken all of us in as your own, and your kids have become another grandchild to hug. We have also witnessed what a loving mother you are, Noah, not only to your four, but Noah as well. You have put forth a much-needed effort in helping him become more confident and secure so he knows that he is a very important member of this family and that he is so loved by you. We know that as he grows up, he will always have you to help him through whatever difficulties he will face, and you will be there for him like only a good mother can do. It takes a special woman with special qualities to be a great mother to her husband's child, and you are that woman. We are amazed how you put yourself through school with four kids and now five, and now holding down a 40-hour prestigious job that you worked so hard to get. It makes us so happy that you are the reason Trevor's smile and laughter have returned. He is the new Trevor. He loves all the fatherly duties and making you happy and wanting to succeed beyond his expectations. We have noticed a sparkle is back in his eyes. You have also given him a reason to get up in the morning. And for all of us here that knew Trevor when he was in high school and college, we say that is reason enough for him to marry you. So welcome to our family. We look forward to many years together experiencing all the wonderful times we will have in the future. In closing, I would like to read a quote by Mark Twain. To get the full value of joy, you must have somebody to divide it with. So we wish you two a lifetime of divided joy.
We love you
both. Part of that traditional best man speech where I sit up here and talk to you for a few minutes about my best friend of 15 years. Now, that is a very long time, and there's some friends here that we have, Ryan and Kara, that have been friends for just as long and longer. But I told you one time, what was I going to do if I were ever presented with this opportunity? I was going to rat you out to your mother.
Somebody videotape this.
So,
got it.
In the spirit of that, we happen to have two sets of parents here that I hope my cord can reach. And I'm going to ask Mr. Randy Martin first. Hi, Randy. Would you like to hear something funny or something serious about your son?
Serious.
Something serious. Okay. So, the first time that Trevor told me, hey, I met someone, I'm like, okay, that's cool. What's her name? Laura. I said, okay. I said, Trevor, you realize that in this place, it's a college town, right? And there's lots and lots of girls floating around here. And you're decently good looking. And you have a pretty good job. He's like, no, I like this one. Well done.
Thanks.
No problem. So,
That was Ellen. Lori? It's like something funny or serious. Funny. Did you know that your son once proposed to a truck?
I remember.
I'm glad you do, because I have two witnesses here to that as well. Ryan and Kara. Yeah. They were there. They were there.
Yeah, they rejected me.
He got down on one knee in a rock driveway.
I'm still heartbroken.
It was a big yellow Ford F-150.
It was pretty.
Penny, something funny or something serious?
I'm going to go with the funny.
You're going to go with the funny? Did you know that your son-in-law and I one time, and I'm ratting myself out on this one too, we went to a driving range in the middle of the night and stole golf balls. We stole golf balls because we wanted to practice. So what we did was we gathered a whole bunch of friends. Kara, you were there for that one too, yeah?
Both of us.
You were there for that one. Stole a whole bunch of range balls, went out to Trevor's house, Brandy and Lori's house, and we hit those things from your front yard. You weren't there. To the field just north of where your house is. They probably are.
Oh my god, the industry fell one more time.
Yeah. Pete, would you like something funny or something serious?
Let's go with funny.
Something funny. Alright. Did you know that your new son-in-law used to speak very, very beautiful Spanish when he was drunk?
We'll get to see that later.
It was glorious. I had to drive him home one time because he was underage. And a little inebriated. And I stop at a stop sign and all of a sudden, Spanish. Just out of nowhere. I was like, what is going on? He does. He has a great list. You stop it. Now, Laura, I have one special for you, and you don't get a choice. Because you get a serious one. Now, everyone is talking about ups and downs and things like that whenever it comes to a relationship like this. And in one of those downtimes that I had personally witnessed, Trevor and I ended up having a very long conversation. And he looked at me and he said, Josh, I love her so much, she is my world. And I had already liked you prior to all of that, but do you remember? Yeah. We just sat out there, and I stopped, and I thought to myself, this is it. This is the one. So it is in that spirit that I know for a fact that, yes, this is it. You're good to go. You're good to go. But I would also like to give a special one from me, and it's kind of funny. The last time this guy texted me, they were getting ready to go on vacation. And also, preface this by saying, he and I had a conversation the other day, and I was like, okay, I have my speech. He said, okay, what's it going to be like? I said, I'm going to keep it PG-13. He's like, they still allow F-bombs in PG-13. I'm like, okay, so I'll make it PG. He said, my whole family's going to be there, and so is hers. I said, okay, I'm going to keep it PG. And he sends me a text right before they go on vacation, and verbatim he says, wake up, bitch, you're my new best friend. I'm in Walmart shopping and just laughed, just out of the blue, like, what's going on with this? And immediately, if anyone knows the quote from that movie, I immediately shout back, are we going to the zoo? It's true. So, I'm going to end by saying I am so happy for the both of you. Laura, thank you for giving my best friend that twinkle in his eye that his mother said. And thank you for being the absolute best friend to my best friend. And I love you both very much.
Love you too.
Salute and toast to you both. Thank you.
Yeah. never tell you. I'm on the mother nature.